since last week, I have applied for at least a good, I'll say, 10, 15 places. I've only gotten two interviews, and one interview was not even looking for anyone. So there's that. I hate the phrase, get a job now. I hate the phrase, get a job, because the phrase, get a job, makes it seem like it's a responsibility of the person getting a job rather than the person who's doing the hiring. Because, like, if it was up to me, I would just walk into a place and just be like, okay, guys, I work here now. Here's my money. Here's how much money I want, X, Y, Z, 1, 2, 3. I'll go ahead and get to work. That's what I would have, like, if getting a job was that easy, that's what I would have done. But that's not the case here. The case is that I have to apply and beg and hope that I get an interview and then get hired. It's a whole process. Fun fact, when I actually got hired in Olive Garden back in Georgia, it took me 6 months. That's a lot of time to not be making money. And I have things I got to pay for. That's the whole reason. Like, that's the whole reason why I'm kind of in a rush right now. I'm in a rush right now because I have things I have to pay for. This car is not paid for yet. It's not paid off yet. I still got like 3 more years on this car. So I need a job tomorrow. Like, damn the home at this point. I just need income. And, like, you know, obviously the obvious option is going to be do crime, you know, like do crime. Or, like, one thing I love is, like, right now somebody is going to watch this video and be like, well, Manny, you know, maybe if you get a haircut, with what money? Maybe if you clean yourself up, with what money? It's a cycle. It's a cycle, you know. It's like, we can't hire the impoverished, even though hiring the impoverished will make them less impoverished. It's a cycle, man. It's a psychotic cycle. I have applied for 15 places in the course since the last weekly vlog and this one. I have been doing nothing but looking for work in two separate cities, by the way, an hour away from each other, Texas City, and now I'm currently in Humble because somebody recommended that I use this app called Variable, and you know, use the app called Variable, and what you do is, you know, like you do the bid, and the catch is that they have to Variable is basically like DoorDash, except instead of delivering food, you're delivering labor. Now you probably might be asking yourself, Manny, how come you're not like delivering food? Because I don't trust this car. This car's been making like weird noises. So I don't know, like, you know, like, where am I going to, like, I don't trust the car. The cars are making weird noises, but I can't get it looked at because I don't have the money. This would be easier to deal with if I just had a place to just take a shower at. You know what I mean? Like, I'm getting used to sleeping in the car. That's no problem with me. All I just need is a place to go and take a shower. That's it. I'm not looking even for a place to move into. I apparently got cousins in Houston that, like, I just can't communicate with. One cousin, if I'm not mistaken, just doesn't want me in her house. I'm giving myself until the end of the week to get hired. If I don't get hired at the end of the week, at the end of this week, I'm just going back to Baton Rouge, licking my wounds, and I'm just, and I can't lie to you, this is the lowest I ever felt, because, like, I've been homeless before, but I've never really been unemployed and homeless. I've always had a job, you know, it was whatever it could be. I always had a job, and I'm really stressed out about that, because it's like, all I really need now is a job. I need income, specifically, I need income just so I can keep this car. By the way, I stand with the actors in the actor strike. I'm not going to roast Carly Russell for the whole abandonment thing. You know, there's been like a whole bunch of issues talking about that. It's just, it's like, if you, the thing, being homeless and being unemployed and being poor in America is a punishment. And it's ridiculous because it was so easy for it to happen to me. I went from having a home and a job in Georgia to just coming here to chase this dream that I had. I've had this dream. Like, if you go back into my earlier videos, I've always wanted to be a professional wrestler. I've always wanted to train at Reality of Wrestling. These are two things that I've always wanted to do. And I said to myself, come hell or high water, I'm going to do it. This is my hell. This is my hell. So how about yesterday? I didn't know that libraries in Texas were closed, right? So I had a really hard time charging my phone up. So that was the thing. I had to go to a Burger King down the street from where I was down the street from where they had Summer of Champions at to charge my phone up. Why can't you just charge it in your car? I don't know. It won't work in my car for some weird reason. So the goal now is to go to a library today and try to go to a library today. You know what I'm saying? Get myself, start applying for more places because that's all I can do is like apply and pray. And people are like, well, you know, what you can do is you can apply for the job. And then, like, call them up and let them know that you applied. I've been doing that. The people who answer, they always say the same thing. We'll look into it. Wait for HR. We'll look into it. Wait for HR. We'll look into it. Wait for HR. There's actually a few jobs on Indeed, right? And what they do is that they be like, you know, oh, we're looking for somebody right now. Urgent, 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 urgent. And I would apply for those jobs. Apparently, it's not urgent enough. Like, I have dishwashing experience. I've worked in a restaurant before. I can help with food prep. I can do trash. I can do cleaning. You know, I push shopping carts. Apparently, I'm so terrible that, like, even Kroger doesn't want to hire me. Like, that's just weird. I've been trying to get a job at Kroger since 2020. And, like, they don't even look at my applications because they're just too busy saying, I'm guessing they're like, where's the whiter names? I don't know. The one thing I know that I'm good at is professional wrestling. That's the one thing I'm aware that I am good at. And I can't even, like, get my foot in the door, man. I can't even, like, I don't understand, like, why is it such a challenge? It's like, I know how to take a bump. I know how to lose matches gracefully. And I don't mind losing matches. But for some strange reason, I can't do it. I can't even get the training to do it. Because my money is so tight that it's all I wanted to do, man. All I want to do is just wrestle. That's it. And now I gotta go back home and start back from square one. Yet again, because I decided to chase my dream instead of be sensible about what I was trying to do. I feel like such a failure, man. Like, this is like. I don't understand. I don't understand how easy it was, man. Like I said, right now, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, at the end of this, you know, what is this? What is this? I don't even know. Well, that's why, because you're dirty. I mean, if I had a place to go clean myself, I would. What happened at the other interview that you had, Brenton? Well, I don't know. I talked to them, and that was it. Well, maybe it was because, don't tell me, don't do that. You weren't at the interview, you don't know what happened. I hate it when people like try to make it seem like, you know, well, maybe if you did, no, you don't get to do that. You weren't there, you don't know what happened. You know what I'm saying? Some people actually do understand that homelessness is a thing. So they look past that. I never felt so ashamed in my life, man. Because all I'm trying to do is just like, you know, I'm trying to, like, I'm doing everything that I know that I can do. I'm applying for jobs. I'm talking to people. I'm trying to be as personable as possible. I'm trying to be as clean as possible. But it's really hard to do that because I don't, like I said, this variable thing I was supposed to do, that was supposed to be the thing that was going to, like, get me out of this rut that I'm in. And nobody is hiring me. Nobody is looking at my account and going, okay, maybe him too. Like, what is it that I've done that was so wrong? Like, why are jobs so hard to get? I'm going to say this again. I stand with the actors. I stand with the actors because the higher ups, the people that are in charge of, like, people that are in charge of things, the shadowy organization that be in charge of everything, all they want to do is just bring as much misery as possible to line up their own pockets. I don't believe that business CEOs and rich people, I don't believe that they actually do any actual work. I think I've said this multiple times before. I don't believe that rich and successful people do any kind of work. Like, they did it back then. They did work back then. But now they're just living off of it. It's basically the equivalent of, like, saying, well, I managed to live this long as an old person because I was a baby once. That's what it sounds like when a rich person says, I work hard. It's like, no, you used to work hard. Like, you know, now you got the government making sure that you don't ever go broke. I'm trying so hard just to get a job, man. Just to get a job. I'm applied for, like, grocery stores. I've applied for fast food place. I'm going to try to get a job at this Whataburger over here. Never mind. Tomorrow. And it says something about open interviews. So now the goal is to get this job at this Whataburger because I need money. This car that I'm in is $600 a month. I don't understand where I went. Like, I shouldn't have never left Georgia. I should have just stayed in Georgia. Why did I think that I was going to just get trained to become a professional wrestler and have my life go the way that I wanted it to go? Why did I think that? Yeah, I'm hurt. I'm very hurt. This isn't wounded. This is pain. Like, this is gonna be like one of my worst memories. I just wanted to wrestle.